So Anthem's troubled development is something a lot of people have speculated on. It's no secret that the game has major problems and was clearly shipped in an unfinished state. Many of the talking points we even see online mention Anthem being in development for more than 6 years, and while that might be somewhat true, it's just part of what makes this very sad story that I'm about to tell you. Anthem's development was deeply chaotic, lacked any form of vision, and it was plagued by indecisions. These are just some of the words used to characterize Anthem's troubled pre-production, and it's been recently revealed in a very extensive piece published by Kotaku. It's very lengthy, so I'm only going to go over the more important bits or the ones that I find more, you know, important. But if you guys want to go ahead and check them out and do an extended read, then I'm going to post the link to the article down below. Nonetheless, let's dive right into it because there is so much to dissect over here. The article goes into an extensive detail on Anthem's entire development cycle from 2012, when it was first being teased, all the way up to the present day. It seems that despite being 6 years in the works, Anthem's development, much like Andromeda's development, only started amping up in the last 12 to 16 months leading up to the game's release date. There were many people who worked on Anthem in one way or another that were interviewed for this piece, so there's a lot of feedback being provided. There's also a lot of detail on how the game has been progressing through the years, or should I say, not progressing through them or through the vast majority of them. And if you think Mass Effect Andromeda had it rough, let's just say that you're in for quite a surprise, and I don't mean that in a good way, actually quite far from it. So to start things off, Anthem's original name wasn't even planned to be Anthem. BioWare initially intended for the game to be called Beyond, and that made sense. I mean, you fight beyond the walls of the city in which you're feeling safe. The decisions to change that name to what we all know today happened last minute, and because, and I quote, acquiring the rights to the trademark would be too difficult. That would normally not be a big issue, it's understandable. I mean, it's trademark issues, you can't really go ahead and pick any name you want to. But the change happened literally weeks, if not days, prior to the 2017 E3 conference, exactly when the game's first gameplay trailer was first ever revealed. For the people working on the game, though, this was just another common occurrence in a long string of complex problems, as the game already spent years floundering in pre-production and many features weren't finalized or even implemented until the final month. So, you know, a lot of talk that is very disheartening right now is especially for somebody who's a major BioWare fan, who has grown up with many of its games, and who was really hopeful to see, you know, the game succeed, the company succeed as a whole, but it seems that it constantly hits its head against the same problems. We're gonna go over this, and it's all going to make sense as this video progresses. Now, the overall story in Anthem is that of a quote-unquote indecision and mismanagement, according to the article. It's a story of technical failings as EA's Frostbite engine continues to make life miserable for many of BioWare's developers. A story of understaffed departments struggling to serve their team's needs, of two studios, which are Edmonton and Austin, becoming resentful to one another, and of course, that of a game that's been in development for 7 years but didn't enter production until the final 18 months. Of course, these are just some of the problems. Another major issue the studio was facing was people simply quitting. Many of the BioWare veterans that worked on the previous titles have left for various reasons. A constant thing that was brought up was how stressful the environment was and how stressful it was working in these conditions, with many team members having to take quote-unquote stress leaves for months at an end and sometimes not even daring to come back. And this wasn't something that happened just with Anthem, heck, not even with Andromeda. This is something that was reported at the very least ever since Dragon Age Inquisition. Of course, back then we had no idea about this. The constant mistakes and unwillingness to change has cost BioWare way too much at this point. What was once one of the most reputable studios in the industry, thanks to their amazing storytelling and amazing overall games, has since been reduced to nothing but mockery and a source of memes. And it's such a shame seeing so much potential going down to waste. The article also goes into a lengthy detail on how the game's development started and what that initial idea was. For instance, the game was always planned to be an online multiplayer game, so no, there was no strange decision to bring it from single player to multiplayer because of Destiny or Division or whatever, but it wasn't always planned to be a looter shooter, the kind that you'd grind out missions for new weapons, for example. Even Anthem's planet was reported to be sort of like the Bermuda Triangle of that universe that would constantly pull in alien ships and hazards, which in turn would make the planet feel, you know, more filled with dangerous creatures and hazardous. It was initially compared to games like Dark Souls and Shadow of the Colossus by the members who were contributing to creating Anthem, and the initial plans were to add huge creatures that the players would need to fight with. There were even like initial concepts where players were able to attach themselves to these creatures in order to deal damage to them, so very close to how Shadow of the Colossus is playing. Of course, back then the focus was more on surviving dangerous encounters, like for example fighting inside an erupting volcano as a team, and less about hoarding loot. Occasionally, when you would get back home, you would scrap some alien ships or other stuff like that and get some loot in the process, and that initial idea is what made so many of the core members who were initially working on the project to be so hopeful about this game. The general concepts, like using an exosuit for example, going beyond city walls in very dangerous environments, fighting with monsters, was always planned in the game, but there were always plans for so much more. Of course, theory all sounds nice on paper, and all games go through these brainstorming sessions or phases where big ideas get mentioned, but of course as time goes by, some of these ideas are left behind. But BioWare was not just doing that, it was also facing a huge problem, and that was of course of a technical nature. The question that remained was now, how many of these ideas and prototypes would even actually work at scale? Even more so that this game was fully developed on the Frostbite engine from scratch, by the way. At some point, the article even mentions how BioWare didn't want to straight out rip features from Dragon Age Inquisition, for example, just so it doesn't feel too similar to that, as they wanted to bring a new experience. So what they did is they created everything from scratch in it, which was extremely difficult. And this game engine, it barely works for RPGs, and it proved to be a challenge from the get-go and something the studio simply couldn't overcome. Of course, BioWare did manage to make some miracles, but too often even small problems couldn't be fixed in a timely manner. Even something as common as a bug, which would otherwise take a developer a day to fix by himself, could end up taking several days up to a week of going back and forth until it was finally fixed, and even then many of the times the fixes weren't even properly implemented but rather hacked in, as the game engine is simply not made for these kinds of games. But of course, since this is EA's decision to unify the development process through all of its studios, it's not like BioWare had any other choice. It's also noteworthy how little help BioWare received from the Frostbite support team, and by the way, EA does have a quote-unquote support team for Frostbite. Of course, you will soon find out why that doesn't work out that great. According to the statement made, BioWare with its RPGs simply wasn't making enough for EA, at least not even close as much as, for example, games like FIFA or Battlefield, which meant it received a much lower priority when it came to receiving help from the Frostbite support team. Now, of course, this doesn't mean that the entire blame is only on EA. This doesn't mean that the studio itself, that BioWare themselves, didn't have their own issues. And as time went by, the article states that it became clear that some of the Anthem's original ideas either wouldn't work or weren't quite solidified enough to be implemented. Even the flight mechanic, to give you an example, which is such a core feature in Anthem, was added and taken out of the game several times. Each time there were major changes to the traversal in the game, the world also had to be changed in the process, either by flattening or stretching it to accommodate with the new movement style. In fact, only a few years in is when BioWare finally nailed down the flight and finally decided upon having it as a feature in the game. The story itself also didn't fare too well. It got left hanging once David Gaider, one of the veteran writers for the Dragon Age series, who was later moved to Anthem, also left BioWare in early 2016. So with people moving left and right and even quitting altogether, instability had become part of the course on the Anthem team. It also didn't help the fact that Anthem's leadership was accused of indecision and mismanagement many times and by many people. The root cause of all of this was the lack of vision, according to a former BioWare developer who chose to remain anonymous. It seems that for the better part of Anthem's development cycle, nobody knew what this game was or what they were even making. There was a constant talking point always being brought up, and that was of course the BioWare magic, when no matter how rough a game's production might be, things always come together in the final months. And of course this was mostly referencing Dragon Age Inquisition, but somehow that game pulled together, it was critically acclaimed, it even had a game Game of the Year edition. It was an overall very good game that I really, really loved. But yeah, that was just one of the games. Since then, BioWare had only constant failures. The leadership have been reported to never being able to even settle on anything. Most people working on it didn't even know exactly what it was or what it was supposed to be because it kept changing so much. And this is most obvious when you check out the 2017 gameplay trailer. You see how much different, basically a whole different concept compared to what Anthem is currently. So what this means is that all the way up to 2016, there was little progress to be made. The online infrastructure wasn't even fully made, nobody has decided on how missions would even work, and even more so, the basic gameplay has yet even to be decided. The story, as previously mentioned, now with the main writer gone, constantly kept changing and many ideas had to be scrapped altogether. Some of the cool ideas that I wanted to bring up are, for example, the fact that the game was supposed to have multiple cities, then it was supposed to have player-created outposts, and even the mobile Strider that was mentioned like months leading up to the game's release, even that one was scrapped eventually, even though you can access it in-game by mistake thanks to a certain bug. So yeah, there's a lot of talk here that I could go over. The article itself is absolutely lengthy, but I do want to finish this video on a certain note. I don't want to distract from the fact that BioWare also has its own problems and did have a play into Anthem's, well, failure if you wanna call it like that, but the game was pretty much rushed out the window because EA gave an ultimatum to BioWare to release Anthem no later than March 2019, as that was the end of the fiscal year. Also, through the development cycle, of which most of the progress was made in the last 16 months leading up to the game's release, the team faced the exact same issues that it had ever since Andromeda and ever since Dragon Age Inquisition. The game can create beautiful worlds, but it's not fit for RPGs. Unfortunately for Anthem, that was already too late, as development started already since 2012, no matter how little progress was even made. It was already too late to even change anything, and it's also noteworthy that EA pretty much forces all of its studios to use the same game engine. On top of this, if the reports are true, it also seems that getting any sort of help from the Frostbite team is heavily dependent on how much money you bring to EA. And also, I'm going to end it with the fact that there is also a post from BioWare on the topic. They also came in with their own response, saying that they felt that there was an unfair focus on specific team members and leaders through the article, and that despite all of these problems, they still remain faithful to their fans, that they are planning to continue developing and improving Anthem. What the truth is, I don't know, but it's getting too late to even enter this kind of analysis. I'm probably going to come up with a follow-up video tomorrow on a lot more details on the subject, but right now, I need some sleep. So I'm gonna see you guys later.